All right, we need some wheels. This one's unlocked.
An SUV? Look, we're trying to elude someone. We're not driving to soccer practice. Let's take this one.
You like that color?
What's wrong with the color?
I don't know. It's just, it's so dark.
Well, yes, but it doesn't show dirt.
What?
It doesn't show dirt.
I guess.
You know, this really is the first place we've gone to. Perhaps we should try another lot.
Sold.
Hi, I'm Peter Griffin of the New England Patriots. I'm here to kick off the touchdown of savings weekend at Wilkins Hyundai and Subaru. We will blitz the competition, and in no time, you'll be driving your new Hyundai or Subaru right to a touchdown. At Wilkins Hyundai and Subaru, we have Hyundais and Subarus.
You know what? I think I'm gonna go with this one. Guy said it's the newest version. Just came out this week.
Yeah, good call, Quagmire. You're gonna be like the first guy in the neighborhood to own a Model T.
See ya, suckers. I'll be there an hour after you with throw-up all over my legs.
I can't believe you saved all those.
You think Lois will like these?
You love Lois.
Shut up.
You know what? Give me your keys.
I'm fine.
Yeah, no, give me your keys.
I'm driving. Wait.
Give me your keys. You're too drunk.
I'm okay.
Peter, Meg, Brian, you're too drunk to drive.
You're right. Here you go.
I'd like to add another bit of pointless confusion that will make sense later. Let's everyone drive somebody else's car.
Someone can take my coupe.
I'm riding with Gatsby. I don't care which car.
I'll take someone in Daisy's car.
I don't think Daisy said you could drive her car.
Tom, why don't you take Jay's car?
Who's Jay?
Gatsby.
Okay, I have never heard anyone call him that.
Look, if you're in your own car, you're in the wrong car.
What? This one time, me and Joe and Quagmire made a bet to see who could drink the most beer and still drive. And you know that water slide in South Elborough?
Wait, let me guess. This is because of the Redneck Comedy Festival, isn't it?
Oh, that dog of mine! All right, let's head out. Wait, but first, I want to see if we're in the funny horn era. Aha, we are! Me. I'm very sunburned. Go, crappy car, go!
Almost home. Oh, my God! Please be okay. Please be okay. Please be okay. Oh, thank God.
Nothing like drive time radio to remind me that I don't make enough to afford satellite radio.
Hey, you're listening to WQHG 97.1, and we are Devin and Lawrence, formerly known as Weenie and the Butt.
That's right, Devin. Those nicknames no longer fly ever since several women came forward with allegations of sexual misconduct against each of us.
Devin and Lawrence.
Sexual misconduct, 97.1 FM.
Rebranded to phase out Weenie and the Butt.
WQHG 97.1.
They got me tooed, me tooed, me tooed.
But there were still 6 months on their contract. Overlooking that for now.
FM.
Devin and Lawrence.
Court ordered overcorrection.
Damn it, what's wrong with the AC?
And don't forget, Quahog is expected to experience record high temperatures this week, according to our respected meteorologist, Dr. Jessica Sturgis, formerly known as Weather Girl Auga Knockerson.
Yeah.
Sir, could you please roll down your window?
I can't. I spilled honey on it and it won't move.
Please just step out of the vehicle. Sir, you were swerving back there. Plus, you're drowning in sweat. Have you been drinking?
No, I don't start drinking until I drive home.
Why are you slurring your words?
Sorry, I had Cap'n Crunch for breakfast. The roof of my mouth is in shreds.
I find that story relatable. You're free to go.
Man, I can't believe that cop thought I was lying.
Is the lady who owns the Prius here?
Actually, that's me.
Oh, well, your wife's car is totaled.
It's my car.
Sorry. We were, however, able to save your purse.
It's a gender-fluid Eurocarrier.
Either way, we'll have it towed back to San Francisco.
Hey, there are plenty of closer gay cities, you big ape. How did this turn into my fight?
You're gonna need a loaner. We have a pink Volkswagen Beetle you might feel comfortable in.
Ooh, Brian, we could be two in the pink! Take that one, take that one!
I'm thinking of something sportier.
The red Miata it is.
Give me your manliest car!
Bill, I need a Hummer.
Again? You're insatiable.
Wise guy.
Wow, that thing's big.
Brian, it's night now.
Stewie, why did you do it?
You were having so much fun, Bri. Besides, the earth is on fire. One dog driving a Prius won't fix that.
Where to?
Let's do donuts on Mark Ruffalo's lawn.
Yeah! Woo! Come on, you guys, knock it off!
Hey, why don't you turn into the Hulk? Oh, right, you're just a Hollywood sissy.
I'm calling the cops.
Oh, you hear that, Brian? Hulk's calling the cops.
Turns out old Mark really was the Hulk. And Brian and Stewie got tossed clear up to New Hampshire. I'm Sam Elliott. This concludes your B story.
Yeah.
It's me. Can you change the station?
Five different stations, all playing Lick It Up by Kiss. Hummer.
Well, it's nice of you to once again drive me to daycare, Brian.
Sure. It's only three clicks away. I just hope I don't get branded a Hummer guy. I can feel the earth warming. No one needs a car this big.
Yes, but I like how when you cut to an outside shot, Sam Elliott is narrating your drive.
When you need to take a talking baby to daycare, you'll move mountains. And if the mountains won't move, drive right over them. Hummer. And yes, Big Lebowski fans, I've seen the movie. I don't need to hear the lines.
Peter, you can't drive a car over that. You're gonna get hurt.
Lois, I don't come down to Burger King and tell you how to do your job.
Peter, I don't work at Burger
King. I don't work at Burger King. I'm busy. Now, if you'll excuse me, I have some death to defy. Wow, this is just like what happened with Matthew Broderick, except no one's dead.
You know, Peter, maybe Meg having her own car isn't such a bad idea.
Yeah, I guess so.
What? I have been trying to get a sewing machine for months, but she gets a freaking car just like that?
I hate this place.
Look at all these Hummers. What kind of jerk would drive one of those?
Dude, this car kicks ass, and I can watch Madagascar while I'm driving!
What kind of music do you like, Gloria?
Hippo hop. Woohoo! Yeah, baby!
Dude, those animals are so fucking funny, they make me want to merge without looking! Yeah, Rumsfeld!
Hi there, can I help you folks?
Yeah, my daughter's looking for a car that goes with her personality.
Yes, are the new bulimic cutting mobiles in yet?
This is a 1996 sedan. Excellent gas mileage, airbags, and AM/FM cassette.
I love it! Dad, this is the car.
Yeah, hang on a second, Meg. What can you tell me about this one?
Oh, that's just an old tank I use for those commercials where I declare war on high prices. Now, about that sedan.
Yeah, hang on there, Slick. Now I see your game. We come in here wanting a practical car, but then you dangle this tank in front of me and expect me to walk away. Now, I may be an idiot, but there is one thing I am not, sir, and that, sir, is an idiot. Now, I demand you tell me more about this tank.
Well, if you're looking for quality, then look no further.
That's more like it. Tell me, what are the tank's safety features?
What a good-looking question. 3 inches of reinforced steel protects your daughter from short-range missile attacks.
I see. And does the sedan protect against missiles?
It does not.
Ah, you hear that, Meg? Yeah, it does not protect against missiles. See, these are the questions. This is why I'm here.
Peter, you can't be serious. This is a 30-ton war machine.
I'm still not sure.
Did I mention the tank is a tank?
Sold.
Jeep. The toughest four-letter word on wheels. For the driver who doesn't like to stop going just because they've run out of road.
Ow, my balls!
Head out where the real fun begins.
There was plenty
where
of
the
road
paved
left.
Roads
ah,
leave
my
off.
My balls!
Potholes
it's
and bumps
bumpy.
And ruts can come as they will.
They're getting rattled and
Jeep's
smushed.
Welded, rugged,
Please
and
go
riveted
back on the
frame
road.
Takes punishment in
my
large
balls.
Doses and
I
comes
like safe
back
driving.
For more.
My balls!
All right, Peter. If we're gonna find your car, we gotta think like a car. So let's fill up at that gas station.
I feel sick.
Keep drinking. I prepaid $40.
Homer, maybe we're doing this wrong. Oh, crap.
Hey, wait a minute. This is a great time for me to do my Suzuki Samurai promo. Are you a Hawaii scumbag? Do you chug energy drinks in Arizona? Suzuki Samurai. Ninja name, Garbage Cat.
Great. Not even halfway through Canada and we're stuck.
Oh, hey there. You having some car troubles, eh?
Yeah, we're trying to get to the North Pole. I don't suppose you're from AAA, are you?
Who?
AAA, you know? AAA.
Oh, AA, eh? Hey, I just came from AA.
No, not AA, AAA.
Yeah, that's what I said. AA, eh?
Oh, so you are with AAA?
Oh, no, that's AAA. I just came from AA, eh?
Huh?
Stewie, I think he's just a drunk.
Well, drunk or not, can you help us?
I can if you want to join AA, eh?
No, I'm already a member of AAA. I need help with the car.
Oh, I see. Yeah, looks like you got some water leakage. You might need a hose, eh?
Jose, Roberto, whatever. If you got some Latinos up here that can fix cars, that'd be great.
No, I mean, it looks like you need a part, eh?
Well, yeah, when it's fixed, we can celebrate, but let's deal with first things first.
Well, I can probably take you to a gas station, eh? You have cash, eh?
Well, I don't know. My name carries a little weight, but I don't see how that matters here.
Look, we don't have enough cash to fix the car, and we're kind of on our way to the North Pole.
Oh, a car won't take you there anyway. But if you like, you can take my snowmobile.
Really? You just give it to us?
Oh, sure. That's what Canadian hospitality is all about. If you like, you can have all my money and my leg.
Okay.
Yeah, calm down. People make mistakes. Just look at the original design for the first hybrid car.
Eric, we love the car. We only want to change one thing.
Is it the rapist sign?
Yes, it is the rapist sign.
I quit.
Ah, son of a bitch. Well, I better leave a note. It's the right thing to do.
How are we going to get out of here?
You still got the starting gun?
Yeah.
Give it to me.
Did we just carjack someone?
We sure did, Brian. We sure did.
All right, that about does it. Isn't she beautiful, Brian?
The Duke boys would be proud, Peter.
Yeah, and you gotta get in through the window like this. Okay, now you. Oh, sorry, I forgot to roll yours down.
That was bad.
Yeah, times have changed. 3 years ago, I would have been a hero.
3 years ago, they would have been 12. I need a nap. Brian, turn on the heat and NPR.
We now return to NPR's Fresh Air.
My guest today is a white music writer who has written a book about the history of hip-hop.
Stewie's loss. I'm sure this will be an enriching discussion.
Hip-hop has its roots in the call-and-response tradition of the Southern Black Baptist Church.
Well,
a nap was just what the doctor ordered. I feel like a new...
And of course, you can't write a history of rap without mentioning Gil Scott-Heron.
Peter, please. I saw an ad for a used car that would be perfect.
Oh, no, Lois. No, a guy at work bought a car out of the paper. 10 years later, bam, herpes. I'm buying our car from a dealer, and that's that. Oh, look. Oh, aren't you beautiful? Yeah. Yeah, you like that, don't you? Yeah, you're a bad little car. What's that? You want me inside you?
Peter, look at this one. It's safe and reliable, and we can afford it. I'll just see if I can find a salesman.
Hey, I'm Doug. Nice to meet you. Whoa, have you lost weight?
No, it's still there. I'm just parting it on the side.
We were more interested in that car over there.
Lois, let me handle this.
Peter, this car has dents in it, and it's got a cardboard steering wheel.
Yeah, just a second, honey.
And look, there's no engine. It just has a drawing of an engine.
But it only had one previous owner. James Bond.
I'll take it. Okay, let's see what this baby can do, eh? Well, I'm sure the dealer will take care of it.
Hey, just so you know, we're not listening to a radio station. We're listening to the hiss between two radio stations. Whoa, watch your driving. Is he sleeping? Hey, wake up! Wake up! You, lady, wake him up!
You like the Tom and Jerry, do you, dear? Well, we'll dial them up when we get home.
What the hell are you talking about? We're about to...
Oh, what happened?
Where are my knitting needles? Goodness, dear, I'm so sorry.
No worries. Now I can work at Hot Topic and make people sick as I ring up their purchases.
Aw, oh, damn it!
Dude, bad news. You're dead.
What? But I'm death.
Sorry, dude. Super death. You're done.
So, what now? I go to heaven?
Nope. When a death dies, he gets reincarnated. You're being reincarnated as a Chinese baby right now. Girl?
Girl.
Oh, no! The egg that I was supposed to take care of for my high school project! Mr. Burke was right. I'm not ready to be a parent. Wait a minute. I'm not in high school anymore. Maybe this is all a dream. Ah! It was a dream. I need a glass of water. Wait a minute. I moved out of the desert years ago. Maybe this is a dream. Ah! Whew. I am ready to be a parent, Mr. Burke.
Come on, Joe. Let's put this 70 siren on your car and go.
Did you just wipe a booger on my roof?
Let's go!
Boy, what a great day for a baseball game.
Yeah, and these are the best seats in the house for catching home run balls.
Oh, that'd be sweet. The only souvenir I ever got was at that stock car race. All right, I got the guy.
Here you go. And if you'd like to put your email on our sign-up list, I'd be happy to sell it to Russian hackers.
Peter, it's happening!
What?
The Bing Maps car! It's 3 blocks down and it's coming this way!
Holy crap, this is the day we've been waiting for! We said we're gonna stand in our front yards and wave as it goes by so we're on the street view!
We're gonna be on the internet!
Bork just called. It went by his house. Everybody places start waving! This is not a drill!
Damn it! I can't fit through the door! I'm stuck in a truck!
What? What are you talking about?
I knew this would happen. You're too fat to get out.
I see it! I see the Bing car!
Oh my God, Bing! Bing! Over here, Bing!
They can't see you, Peter. You're facing away from the street.
Stop talking, Quagmire. Just smile. This is amazing.
Crap! Is it gone?
The driver nodded at me. I think I'm gonna cry.
Hey, look at all these videos Mr. Quagmire's selling.
Wow, the best of the world's wildest police chases. And it even has the one with the Flintstones.
Amazingly, this drunk driver turns left into oncoming traffic. He narrowly misses hitting a pedestrian, who jumps out of the way just in time. Now the driver can add attempted battery to the charges. The driver turns right into the parking lot of a drive-in movie theater. At this point, the dinosaur in the back seat pokes his head up through the roof, and the driver places two small children on top of it. Now he's not only endangering his own life, but their lives as well. The driver totals the car and makes a run for it, but the pursuing officers are prepared. Running from the cops, yabba dabba don't.
It's okay. Peter's got you. Don't you worry. Everything's gonna be all right.
Is my wife okay?
No, the ski boots that was in the back flew up and chopped her head off. You can turn your blinker off now. It's very annoying.
Are you here against your will, sir?
If you're asking if I'd rather be at the zoo, then yes.
Maybe you step out of the car and we see if you've been drinking.
I'm too fat to be in the car by myself.
What is this? This is a weird gun.
Yeah, don't touch that.
Oh, it's a flare gun.
Maybe you should put that back.
I'm just holding it. Is this the trigger?
Oh my God, Stewie, are you all right? What the hell happened?
Just some stupid stuff went down.
You could have been killed!
Hey, you're not in uniform. Are you guys cops?
Are you guys cops?
They know we're not cops!
Very persuasive. That's why I was so good at selling low-cost car insurance. White trash rates from an army guy. Here is a penguin, don't know why.
The General Car Insurance. It'll worry whoever you hit.
Thanks for the ride, Bandit. Good luck tapping some of that hot, hot Sally Field tail.
Knock it off. I don't like it any more than you do.
Well, I say, that was a pleasant surprise. You know, like when a woman in a Porsche Cayenne isn't a complete bitch. Wow, I did not expect that.
I wasn't telling you to go. I was trying to smell my own fart.
I, too, will be abstinent. I'll be as untouched as the turn signal in an Asian woman's car.
How much signal I need to cut across 8 lane? None? I turn now. Good luck, everybody else!
All right, Meg, now here's your first lesson. Now, you always want to be aware of other cars on the road. And if you ever catch eyes with a guy next to you at a red light, you gotta race him. Oh, this guy's asking for it.
But, Dad...
I don't make the rules, honey. Now, rev your engine twice.
Okay.
Go. You forgot to flip him off, but other than that, nice job.
And now, the History Channel presents American Inventor, the true story of Henry Ford.
This is my Jew flattening machine. It'll flatten any Jew. Simply climb behind the wheel, drive it towards a Jew, and flatten him.
Could you also use it just to drive from place to place and stuff?
It's a Jew flattening machine. It's not what it's designed for.
But you could use it that way.
Yeah, you could also use the Mona Lisa as a placemat. God!
I take a picture with a giant Samsung phone. Giant Samsung phone is also a tiny Kia car.
Around the park one more time, Bitterman.
Peter, I'm not your chauffeur.
Not for long with that attitude, Bitterman. Ah, this is living, Bitterman. This set of wheels is even better than those talking cars on that commercial.
Hey, how you doing there? Listen, couldn't help but notice you across the parking lot, and, you know, you're very attractive, and, you want to go behind the Applebee's and do it? Huh? You want to just go have some dirty, stupid, insane parking lot sex?
Chuck, it's me, Morty.
Yeah, because we could... What?
Yeah, they had me painted.
Oh my God, I'm so embarrassed.
Hey, how do you think I feel?
No, that too, but...
It's not all about you, you
Morty,
know.
Oh my God, what are you doing?
I think I was
doing?
Like a birthday present for the kid or something like that.
Oh my God, look at you. You're hot.
I know.
I would have taken... You know what I would have done to you back there? Why didn't you say something earlier? I said all that stuff.
Well,
God.
Let's not rule anything out.
Wait, Peter, don't go!
So, you changed your mind, huh, buddy? We going to Hollywood?
You betcha. But I have to say, I thought you'd drive a fancier car.
What? Why?
Well, aren't you the Peter Griffin of Peter Griffin Cadillac?
No, that's another guy.
Hi, I'm Peter Griffin. And at Peter Griffin Cadillac, we believe in three things. Fair dealing, family, and friendship. I've lived in Quahog my whole life. I love it here. And you're gonna love a Peter Griffin Cadillac.
Scumbag. All right, red light. Time to text and shave and whittle and floss.
Thanks for getting here so quickly.
What?
I'm sorry, you're in a Prius. I just assumed you were my Uber.
I don't know what that is on account of being dull.
Uber. It's like a cab, except it feels like a game because it's from your phone. Anyway, I'm late for a meeting. Can I just give you $20 to drop me off?
Wow, $20 just to drive you across town? Maybe I should be an Uber driver. I mean, I could use the extra money, and it's got to be easier than when I was delivering pizzas. All right, push. Push. Come on. Almost there. Almost there. Just one more push. Here it is. Oh, it's half Hawaiian.
I believe that's ours.
You poor fool. Hi, I'd like to be an Uber driver.
Okay, sure. Welcome aboard.
Don't I need to fill out a form?
Oh, right. Yeah, of course.
Name, Peter Griffin. Criminal history. This section is optional. I will skip this. And done. Here you go.
Yeah, none of this really matters. All I need to know is, do you have a car, a phone, and a face?
It's my dog's car. Oh, and I know you didn't ask, but I am quick to anger.
Okay, great. Now get out there and try to kiss as many ladies as you can. The record is 60 in a month. You, sir, are officially an Uber driver.
Where are you headed?
The airport.
Great, just a couple of errands and we'll get you there. That was one bitch of a clash. Anyways, what time's your flight?
It's in 20 minutes!
Oh boy, I can't make it in 20 minutes. I better call you a Lyft. Come on, hurry up, get in! I hope you like the offspring. Let's go!
Hey, what's up? I'm just going to Quahog Stadium.
Okay, would you like the AC on or the windows down?
How about both? Pretty great, right?
It is! It really is! Thank you, genius person!
No problem. Hey, you ever go in a hot tub when it's snowing outside?
What?! Hey, pal, where are we heading again?
Just go down this dark alley.
What the hell's going on?
This is what we do to Uber drivers in this town.
Stop! Stop! Please stop! The sound of your leather jackets is excruciating!
You can't just buy a phone and become a cab driver!
Please! I have two families!
Stay back!
Where did you get that?
Judd Hirsch himself. I was a boy, no more than 11 or 12. Was on the side of the road. Man with a hat pulled up next to me. Said I reminded him of him when he was my age. I was just a boy husking corn. Didn't know what it meant. Of course, we were all husking corn back then, just to keep the lights on. And you burned my car while I was telling my fake Judd Hirsch story.
Okay, Rupert, you ready to go for a drive?
my God, Rupert, this is such a thrill. Look at me, I'm driving. I'm driving a real car. I don't believe it.
Well, I'd say we need to put on some tunes.
Hey, welcome back to Weenie in the Butt on 97.1.
97.1. Ooh, Weenie in the Butt, just like the grown-ups listen to.
And that was Baby by Justin Bieber featuring Ludacris, which means it's time to give away some Justin Bieber tickets. Oh, that's right, Butt. Our fifth caller will ween those tickets.
Fifth caller, caller number 5.
Not 4, not 6.
Oh, 5.
Cinco, cinco, cinco!
Hey, you know what, Rupert? You know what I should do just, like, as a goof? I should try to win those Justin Bieber tickets just so I can, like, tear them up or use them to go to the concert. Oh, it's ringing, Rupert. It's ringing. Oh, I'm too nervous. They're celebrities. You talk to them. Oh, God. Oh, my God, I'm in so much trouble.
Congratulations, you're caller number 5. You're going to see Justin Bieber.
Oh, sweet Jesus. Yes, Jesse, I won. Never say never.
See you at the Moon Tower.
You know it.
Hey, Woodison, see you at the Moon Tower?
Nah, I'm just going to drive around in my Lincoln. Weird people out. Bells on bobtail ring, making the spirits bright. Oh, what fun to laugh and sing a sleighing song tonight. Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a Lincoln AKZ.
The Family Guy Christmas Special, brought to you by Lincoln. Lincoln, what are we doing?
Ski in!
All right!
Water sitting!
You gotta cut to the right.
No, no, it's counterintuitive. You gotta cut left.
I know how to drive. Stop looking at us!
Maybe we won't be going water skiing today.
Shut up, Joe.
Hey, you want some help? I do this all the time.
Get back in your car with your wife.
When you're going backwards, everything's the opposite.
Oh, really? Thanks, driving instructor. I feel like everyone watching knows I'm incapable of pleasing my wife sexually.
Now cut the wheel! Cut the wheel!
No, the other way!
Ah, hell, we're gonna be on the internet. You know what? Screw it.
That was fun. I like Gavin. Oh, yay, this is such a great song.
Really?
Yeah, really. I don't have to defend Carrie Underwood to you. She is doing just fine without you. Brian, I'm just going to sit in the car till the song's over.
All right, but don't take too long. It'll drain the battery.
Oh, shut up. It's not draining the battery. I took a Louisville Slugger to both headlights. I slashed a hole in all four tires. Maybe next time he'll think before he cheats.
I should be on Glee. I should be on Glee. Oh, my God. I just drove. That was amazing! I can drive!
Now I can do a slow cruise past my ex-girlfriend's apartment. 11:45 and the lights are on. Doing it with the lights on now, whore! Don't mind looking at his body! I love you so much, though.
Kids, where's your father?
He left a note. If Van Halen calls, tell them they rule.
What?
Did they call?
Peter, what are you doing?
I did what you wanted. I went to the library and I got 1984. What a book!
Peter, I'm not okay with this new Van Halen phase of yours.
Yeah, Dad. It's crazy. Like JFK deciding to cruise through Dallas in a rental.
How'd that convertible work out for you?
Yeah, I don't know. Good. Okay.
And did you get all your stuff out of the car?
Kind of.
All units, this is dispatch. We've got a red station wagon blasting Panama and being awesome and partying and being rad.
Not in my town, dispatch. This is Officer Stickbutt in pursuit.
Stickbutt, break off pursuit. Panama kicks too much ass and shreds way too hard. You'll never catch him.
Negative, dispatch. Just need to wait for that running a little bit hot tonight part.
Yeah, we're running a little bit hot tonight.
Bingo. Got him now.
I can barely see the road from the heat coming on.
What's he doing? Suspect is headed toward Unjumpable Canyon. It's totally unjumpable. Unless...
Unless what, Stickbutt? Over.
Dear God, he's gonna do it. He's gonna time his jump for the greatest harmonized sound drop in 80s rock history.
You're right. The part that goes, ain't no stopping now.
Damn it!
What? What happened?
Get off this channel, Joe.
Come on, I want to be an outside cop.
I guess my Van Halen days are over. No. Those days are behind me. I made a promise to a pancake.
On and on, he just keeps on trying. And his smile when he feels like crying. On and on, on and on.
Working squirrel.
What the hell are you doing? Where's Quagmire?
Oh, he said to go on without him.
We're stealing the Winnebago, aren't we?
Oh, you can read me like a book, Brian.
Breaker, breaker, sidewinder, this is Party Pooper. Don't want to be a ratchet jaw, but looks like we've got a seat cover feeding the bears in a chicken coop. Come on.
He's pounding down, loaded up and trucking. Are we gonna do what they say can be?
Are you all right?
Never better! I got some pep pills from a trucker at the last stop! Keeps me awake!
You took pills?
West Coast turnaround! Trucker said to only take one, but I took all of them!
Look, maybe you should slow down.
Why? We're making good time!
We're not even on the road.
Huh?
I said we're not even on the road!
Don't need to be! Compass says west! That's where we're headed!
Stewie, we're in the middle of the desert.
I know! Imagine the nads on those guys who did this in a wagon! Pioneers, Brian! We share their spirit! Manifest destiny!
All right, that's it. Give me the wheel.
Go to hell!
Can you believe I'm stuck with Meg driving me around?
Dad, it's just you and me in the car.
Yeah, don't remind me. It's bad enough I got a suspended license. I gotta ride around town with stinky McPoop pants. I want apple juice!
Dad, you left your apple juice at home.
I want apple juice!
You wanna watch SpongeBob?
Yes. With apple juice. SpongeBob.
All right, Brian, let's begin.
Great, let's do it.
Whoa. Stop! Demerit!
What the hell?
Where are your hands, Brian?
On the steering wheel.
10 and 2. All right, commence. IPD, Brian, IPD!
What?
IPD. Identify, predict, decide, execute.
You've got to constantly be IPTing everything in your target zone.
I don't know what you're saying.
IPTI, identify, predict.
Yeah, you said that, but it doesn't mean anything.
IPTI that!
It's a child with a ball.
Very good. Identify. Now, predict.
Predict what?
IPTI!
Yeah, you keep saying that like it's a word. Those four letters don't make a word. It's not helping me remember anything.
Oh, now you've got an oncoming vehicle. Pay attention to your 4 to 6 second zone.
What is that? Four to six second?
IPTI the car, Brian! IPTI the car!
What does that mean?
Now check your gauges with one eye while keeping your other eye on the road.
My eyes go in the same direction.
What's your tire pressure?
I'm in the car!
Stop! Demerit!
Stewie, I know how to drive. I've been driving for years.
Ever hear of IPTI, jackass?
Hey, listen, sorry about beating you up. I felt pretty bad about it. Hey, this look like a spaceship to you?
Sorta.
Huh. Well, I never was very good at building things. Like that time I built that gay car alarm.
Hey you, hey you, hey you. Ooh, ooh, ooh. Want me, want me, want me. Pooper.
Where are you gonna go?
I don't know. Somewhere far away. Maybe China. I hear they got NASCAR there now.
No way! Those guys have a TV in their car! They're watching Operation Dumbo Sex with Don Nuts.
Professor, you've got to impregnate this elephant or the entire species will become extinct.
You mean I gotta put this thing in that thing? Well, this is a job that's not worth the money!
PETA, watch the road!
Lois, get off my back, will you? I'm trying to watch TV!
I swear to God, sometimes I think your head's screwed on backwards. I mean, do you have any idea?
Hey, Crashy! What are you doing down there?
My name is Greg, and, I'm an alcoholic.
Hi, Greg.
One fateful night, I got behind the wheel of my brand new sports car, blind drunk. I was responsible for the death of an innocent 8-year-old girl.
What kind?
What?
What kind of car? You said you had a sports car. That's cool, but what kind?
It was a Miata.
Oh, come on. That's not a sports car. How does that even kill a kid? What'd you hit her over the head with it?
That's a legitimate sports car.
Nope. Next.
What's all this?
Oh, hey, guys. Sadly, my Uncle Ray passed away last week, but he left me his vintage sports car.
Joe, that's amazing that your uncle died.
But I'm really sorry to hear about the car.
He means that the other way around.
Mr. Firestone says hello.
Ow! 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 Stop it! Stop it! That's him. That's the one who popped me.
Are you sure?
Yes, I'm sure. Did I not sound sure?
Good thing I just watched that National Geographic special on fire trucks.
A solitary killer, the fire truck stalks its prey. The fire truck can consume 8 times its body weight. The ambulances will have to wait their turn.
Now we can live with you again, even though you're a dangerous retard.
Don't say retard, Chris. We prefer to be called little people. Because there's nothing wrong with being mentally challenged. In fact, I've learned that we are superior people. Above all you dumb brainy smarties. Someday you will beg us for mercy. And we will consider it.
Isn't it wonderful that everything's back to normal?
Yeah. Oh, God, nobody move.
What is it?
Nothing. I'll get it.
Enjoy your new car, Mr. Griffin.
Thanks, Jim. Hey, when you pull that thing into your garage, does the garage say, is it in yet? Don't worry, baby. I'll be gentle.
Ha ha ha!
my pride. Honey, I'm taking the compact. Save a little on gas. Cars are bigger back now.
Everything's meant to be broken. I just want you to know.
I'm very easily influenced by music.
Hello?
Hey, Peter, what's up?
Oh, hey, Quagmire. Just taking the family on vacation.
Oh, that's good. Oh, hang on a second. I'm stuck behind some fat ass driving too slow. Come on, stupid, move it!
Now, hang on, Quagmire. Some jerk behind me is honking his horn.
Oh, you should totally flip him off. Oh, hang on a sec. Some fat ass just flipped me off. Hey, up yours, you jerk!
Hang on, Quagmire. I gotta kick this guy's ass.
Yeah, I gotta kick this guy's ass.
Hey, I'll call you back after the fight.
Yeah, me too.
Good luck in yours.
Good luck in yours.
Okay, Joe, you're drunk, okay? You're drunk. Give me your keys. And I'm drunk, so I'll give you my keys. Okay, now we're both good to drive home. You been drinking tonight, sir?
No, officer. I just had a glass of dinner with my wine.
Okay, I'm gonna need you to step out of the car and walk a straight line, please. All right, you be safe, sir. There's a lot of crazies out there tonight.
Hey, look, there's Lois.
Yeah.
Hey, honk the horn.
Oh, hi, Peter.
Rammer.
What?
I said rammer!
What the hell?
Now shoot her tires out.
What?
You got a gun?
Well, yeah, every cabbie carries a gun, but
give me the gun.
What the hell is wrong with you, Peter? You could have killed me!
Yeah, but I got you good, Lois. Admit it. Just say it. I got you.
Oh, all right, you got me.
Come on, get in the car! Oh, really, Lois? I thought I might drive forward. I thought that might be a fun thing to do.
Stop fighting!
Oh, my God! Quick, Peter, get in the back! Oh, thank God! We made it!
Ooh! Oh, ow! My neck! You backed into me, and now... Oh!
And your back!
And my back! My back, yes! Oh!
Ah, there's my silver fox. What are you doing out here?
Well, now that I've got white hair, I fix my car in slow motion in an ad for a supplemental blood thinner. I took Zambrex for over 15 years, till I learned the benefits of once-daily Sanguelto, our latest generation blood thinner.
Peter, I don't think you should be driving with your feet.
Roadhouse.
Wait, why are you taking the back way home? There are so many turns.
Roadhouse. Roadhouse. Roadhouse.
Roadhouse. Roadhouse. Ah, crap. God, I hate cops. Almost as much as I hated my overly sensitive car alarm. Bitch!
Well, I say, that was a pleasant surprise. You know, like when a woman in a Porsche Cayenne isn't a complete bitch. Huh. Well, I did not expect that.
I wasn't telling you to go. I was trying to smell my own fart.
Hey, you cut me off!
What? Turn down your radio.
I can't. My stomach's pressed up against the dial. You want to go? Get me 17 shoehorns and some canola oil and we'll go! Back here!
People of France, a good-looking, depressed guy smoking a cigarette is not a movie. And your sirens sound like gay guys having a threesome.
What a day. I asked Ms. Watson if she had any kids of her own. Immediately, she put me in a timeout. What the hell?
Ay, Dios mio.
Oh, great. Of course it's one of them.
What?
Stewie, adults are allowed to say racist things because of traffic.
Oh, my poor 98 Toyota Corolla. We all have 98 Toyota Corolla.
Okay?
I'm allowed to say racist things because of traffic.
Well, don't get so angry. Just tell your insurance what happened, and then they'll... Oh, you're driving away because you don't have insurance.
This sucks. Fixing the bumper is going to cost at least a grand.
That's right. Get it nice and clean.
Here comes the Rocky and Bullwinkle float. Always a popular sight here at the... Somebody want to handle that? Somebody want to deal with that? The car alarm would. You're kidding. Well, viewers, to top it off, that's the Channel 5 news van you're hearing. Phil, just open it. Unlock the doors. You don't have to put the key in the ignition. Well, open the driver's side first. Okay, well, I guess it's broken then, and there's nothing we can do about it. Okay, happy Thanksgiving, Quahog. Here's a car alarm. All right, well, I guess we'll just... there.
I'm also thinking about ice creams.